Hello, everyone. So today I have a theory, but first of all, you guys haven't seen Otto in a little while. Do you remember what he used to look like?
Oh my god, okay. All right.
I think he's going to just be here today. Are you happy with that, Otto?
Point is, this boy is half a year old. Look at him.
You're like a full cat, aren't you? Mm.
As I was saying, today I have a theory that I want to bring to all of you. You see, in the mainstream media, there's this quite common conspiracy that often celebrities die and are replaced by clones or people that look like them. You've got the usual suspects like Paul McCartney and Avril Lavigne. That would certainly make things complicated. Also, at times, I think that I was replaced by a person that looked like me. Maybe it's just the fact that I've had this beard for over 2 years now, but what is this? I don't know about you guys, okay, but I'm just gonna throw a name out there. Ellen DeGeneres. Ellen has been around for longer than I can remember, and yes, that is a very, very long time. I used to watch all of her clips back in old school YouTube, you know, the days where your recommended would just be filled with clips from talk shows that you don't actually care about. Oh wait, that still happens now. But in comparison to other talk show hosts, Ellen always came off as really wholesome. When I first found out about her, for example, it was because of all the charitable things she did. She used to bring people onto her show and then give them gifts like cars. So how can someone go from doing such life-changing, beneficial things to being described as one of the meanest people alive? Is this the same Ellen, the one that used to jump scare Taylor Swift? Actually, no, to be fair, if you jump scare people, you deserve the death penalty. I'm not sure if any of you have been keeping up to date with this, so I'm gonna read through an article about how mean Ellen apparently is. But before we do that, I also have a little bit more proof that Ellen has been replaced by a lookalike. See, I'm talking to you right now, okay? But I've recorded this video already. I recorded this entire video yesterday. It took me over an hour, and my footage never corrupts. I'm on top of it, man. The only thing that's even a little bit corrupt about me are some of my dodgy tax practices. That's a joke, HMRC. Please don't fist me. So how is it that the one time I address a conspiracy, the footage just dies? I spent money on software to bring back the footage, and nothing worked. So the very fact that you're seeing this video is a miracle, and not because this footage didn't corrupt, just the fact that I'm sat here re-recording a video, that's a miracle. So if you haven't done so already, subscribe to the damn channel. I want 2 million subscribers. Why the tables have turned on Ellen DeGeneres. The very first allegations against DeGeneres weren't regarding any form of strict misconduct per se. People said that she was, to put it bluntly, mean. I mean, if she's been replaced by a lookalike, we might as well change her name from Ellen DeGeneres to Ellen DeTwat. One response from a TV writer claimed that she has a sensitive nose, so everyone must chew gum from a bowl outside her office before talking to her, and if she thinks you smell that day, you have to go home and shower. Okay, we are going to go into a few reasons why I think Ellen is the mean person that is being portrayed here. But having a sensitive nose isn't a problem. If you come near me and you stink, I'm not gonna want to spend time with you. If anything, I wouldn't even give you the opportunity of chewing gum or going home for a shower. If you a stinky boy, then get out of my face. I want nothing to do with you. Imagine being at work and your boss telling you that you could go home to have a shower. That doesn't sound like a bad thing. Apparently, in this case, all of the staff members are anonymous. I'm not surprised, to be honest, because who'd want people to know that they fucking stink? The journalists just jotting down their notes. Oh my god. People have even been rediscovering old clips of Ellen's interviews with celebrities and pointing out how awful she is in them. My favorite one is this one with Dakota Johnson.
You turned 30.
I did.
And how was the party? I wasn't invited.
Actually, no, that's not the truth, Ellen. You were invited. Last year, you gave me a bunch of about not inviting you.
The one thing I can respect about this clip is that it's very honest. They haven't cut anything. Imagine being caught out that badly in your own show and keeping it in. It's almost respectable. But I don't really have an issue with Ellen trying to make this situation awkward per se. My issue is more with the fact that she's done this joke 2 years in a row. No wonder you don't get invited to birthday parties, Ellen. You come off as a massive loser.
Oh, please take me to the prom. Why didn't you invite me to the party?
People probably think that if they invited you and you actually turned up, that you'd see something happen at the party that you could bring up on your show. It would go down like a nonce in a nursery.
Well, I didn't even know you liked me.
Of course I like you. You knew I liked you. You've been on the show many times, and don't I show like?
The worst thing is, throughout this entire bit, Ellen isn't even laughing. Why didn't you invite me to party? You know I like you. Hold on, we need to program in a smile. You've been on my show. This is what I mean. It's not the be kind Ellen DeGeneres that we're used to. I'd even argue that she may have just become a robot. There is no emotion in any of this. But of course, on top of this, there were a lot more serious allegations. One former black employee told BuzzFeed that at a work party, one of Ellen's main writers said, "I'm sorry, I only know the names of the white people who work here." So imagine people are highlighting not only issues of you being mean to people, firing people for having chipped nails even, but then there are also issues of race within your team. Of course, course, Ellen has to do an apology. Now, this is my favourite bit about mainstream media, okay? I love a good apology. I genuinely believe you could punch a child in the face as long as you put an apology about how you're trying to do better. It won't matter. People give way too many second and third chances on the internet. Only stay around to watch people's content if you enjoy the content. Don't watch someone's content because you think they're a good person. And if they do something wrong, stop watching them if you feel uncomfortable about it. In my opinion, this is an S-tier apology for many reasons, which I'm about to get into.
Welcome to season 18 of the Ellen DeGeneres Show. If you're watching because you love me, thank you. If you're watching because you don't love me, welcome.
The reason I like this apology, okay, is it's not your usual apology. She's not using her iPhone camera with natural lighting. It's season 18. It's the first monologue of the season. She's smiling. She's loving it. To everyone calling me a racist, welcome to the show. It's just so brilliantly out of touch. It's almost an art form.
Talking directly to people has been illegal for 6 months, so I have a virtual audience here instead. Here you all are.
I'm sorry, I need to point this out. This isn't about the apology yet. What is the point of having virtual audiences? Do you really think I should have, like, videos of people watching my videos in the background? Like, what does it add to the show? You're not gonna bring them on stage, these massive slabs of humans. Sorry, just a little nitpick.
As you may have heard, this summer there were allegations of a toxic work environment at our show. I know that I'm in a position of privilege and power, and I realize that with that comes responsibility.
Tone it down, Peter Parker. With great power comes great chewing gum. Make sure to use this one before coming into my office. I want you to find me any apology made by someone who is white without the word privilege in it. It simply does not exist, okay? And that's because any celebrity that's the size of Ellen doesn't write their apology on their own. They don't write their monologues on their own. They have a team of writers, and they've all got buzzwords. Responsibility, privilege, striving to become a better person. You can say that again. It just takes the authenticity out of the apology, in my opinion. I'd much rather have a celebrity just come on stage and be completely real. Like, look how perfected this fit is. Come out in a tracksuit with a hoodie on, man. Everyone knows that the only thing that's going through your mind is that you might lose your platform. No one is real in the mainstream media because it pays to be fake. And there you go, that's your daily dose of wokeness.
This is the Ellen DeGeneres Show. I am Ellen DeGeneres. My name is there. My name is there.
Oh no, guys, the clone's trying to convince itself. I am Ellen DeGeneres, even if James Marriott tells me I'm not.
We have made the necessary changes, and today we are starting a new chapter.
One thing I've noticed about this is I pointed something out earlier, didn't I? They are recording this in a studio, but there's a virtual audience. So how is it that I hear regular crowd applause? You've done an apology, right? You've gone in front of the whole world to do this big monologue apology, and you've used canned crowd applause? Even from a PR perspective, imagine how much more powerful it would be if there was no other noise, if it was just you and Ellen apologizing. And that isn't the only time they use some 8-second crowd sound effect that they found on YouTube.
I started saying be kind to one another after a young man named Tyler Clemente took his own life after being bullied for being gay. Let me give you some advice out there. If anybody's thinking of changing their title or giving yourself a nickname, do not go with the Be Kind Lady. Don't do it.
Right, so here we have a case of virtue signaling. So people were saying that Ellen goes against her be kind mantra. Oh, but do you know that she says be kind because someone killed themselves? That is an incredibly devastating thing, and I can understand why someone would base a slogan off of that. Then why make a joke about that slogan, say for other people not to follow that slogan, and then wait for it? Where's the... beep, beep, beep.
Do not go with the be kind lady.
someone died! How can you go from virtue signaling to just completely trampling over that idea within one sentence?
And if I've ever let someone down, if I've ever hurt their feelings, I am so sorry for that.
This is another thing that I don't like about apologies, right? You rarely get people who apologize for their actions. Hey, I did this thing. I'm sorry I did this thing. A lot of people say, I'm sorry if you got offended, or I'm sorry if this upset you. That isn't lamenting the action you did in the first place, right? That's not really saying that you regret being mean. You regret them finding you mean. I'm not gonna come at you from the position of, oh, I've used to love Ellen and now I don't like Ellen anymore. Boo-hoo. I haven't enjoyed Ellen's show in like 7-10 years maybe. But I really want to drive home this idea of you don't need to give people second chances just because of an apology. If you enjoy their stuff, don't feel guilty for watching it, right? But also understand that this is just PR bullshit. I highly doubt that she's sorry for any of the things she did. She's only sorry because they ended up affecting her.
I got into this business to make people laugh and feel good. That's my favorite thing to do. That and Jenga. love that game.
All right, I'm done, all right? She's trying to just be relatable now.
No one plays Jenga anymore.
She even does a little hand action.
As if we don't know how to play Jenga.
Pretty simple, playing Jenga. So I wanted to show you another platform where I've seen Ellen thrive recently. So Ellen almost has 7 million followers on TikTok, even though she barely uses it at all. It's all just clips of other people. As I said, I've already recorded this video. I've already gone through all of these TikToks. It is difficult to find one that she's in. One that I found that is actually Ellen is a, oh baby, I'm baby. And it's just a video of her smiling.
You're not baby, Ellen, you're 70.
There's another video of some of Ellen's staff throwing a banana with forks at each other. To be honest, if I saw that, I'd probably complain about the work environment as well.
Prepare my little letter to BuzzFeed.
Why do I work with such losers?
Oh, what's this? Ellen's standing behind a door.
Oh, the classic, the jump scare. Don't jump scare people. Right, there's this TikTok that went viral here of someone undressing themselves in Ellen's merch.
Is that Comic Sans?
Imagine being such a narcissist that you sell clothing with your own name on it. I mean, when I do it, it's fine, though. I'm not a narcissist. I'm just
well aware that people want to be seen wearing me.
There's a kid here trying to give me a fact, but I don't care because kids are stupid.
Ooh, we got some more Ellen merch here.
I don't think the Be Kind merch is selling that well anymore.
So there's this really sad story about a boy who died, you know, he committed suicide, and so I made a slogan out of it and made millions.
Oh my god, as if it couldn't get any worse.
Of course there are people that stink in your offices. You've hired furries.
Ellen, please be my friend.
God, imagine posting that publicly. For anyone out there that's considering posting that under one of my videos, please don't.
We're not gonna be friends, okay? I only have about 3 friends, maybe 4.
And they're most certainly not people that watch my content, okay? Because none of my friends support me.
The chances of flipping anything other than heads or tails are low, but they're never zero. Watch out for them. Okay, right.
Yeah, that's enough TikTok for today.
All in all, Ellen, I believe she's a clone.
If you've worked for Ellen, if you've even been around Ellen before and you think you have information that could help in my investigation, then do please get in touch. My email is I don't actually care about this. Please leave me alone.
And yeah, before I end this video, I just want to say that right now, as you're watching this video, probably, I am currently in a studio recording the EP that I've been working on for almost half a year now.
And I just wanted to say thank you, because I never really make much of a point of hitting sub goals like 1 million. I always put way too much pressure on numbers, so I feel like the best thing I can do is avoid talking about them. But seriously, none of the things I do would be possible without the support for my videos, for my music, for anything I do, even the tweets that I steal. So yeah, I just wanted to say, seriously, from me to you, thank you for all of the support you've given me. Even if you watched me over a year ago and you just clicked this one, because why not? Or if you watch every single video, you reply to every tweet, you like every Instagram post, my heart goes out to you and I love you very much. And I cannot wait for you to hear the bangers that I've come up with.
Leave a like if you have enjoyed this video, subscribe if you're new or have not done so already. Yes, I do still want 2 million subscribers, make it happen.
And I will catch you next time.